Hello, welcome to the last part of this wrench tutorial. So I'm going to make the last part of it, then we are going to assemble everything in an assembly. So to start, let's just click on the top plane and draw a circle here and draw another circle below it somewhere over there, something like that. And make sure this circle, the center point of that circle, is vertical to the origin point. And we are going to trim this, and the distance between those two is 0.6, and the dimension, add dimension to this, this is going to be 0.52, and the second one is going to be 0.45, and we are going to add two more circles here, and no, just one more. We are going to add this circle, then what we are going to do is add a dimension to it, and that will be 0.56. And also we need something over here, which is also another circle. Every time I try to, I think I'm done, I realize that I need more stuff. So make that a midpoint and make that horizontal. Make this to a construction line and add a dimension to this line, which is going to be 0.433, and add a dimension to this line, which is going to be 0.664. And remember when we did the circle, we're going to add the circle here, the two circles there. Make those two circles equal to each other and add a dimension to it, which is going to be 0.125. Okay, so I believe that's all we need, and what we are going to do is extrude it up, and we are going to extrude 0.08 and click OK. And that is it. We are done with this part. You can add your appearance to it and save it. Just save it as a back cover, and I'm just going to replace that and click OK. And yes, we are done with this part, and now let's just start putting it together in an assembly. So what we're going to do now is open the assembly and new file assembly and click OK. And what I'm going to do is browse to your file location by click. So what you do is click insert components, browse, and select the body. And while you are still kind of like, you can move it around, click the check mark to constrain it. So now that body is fully constrained over there, and that's what you want. And now we are going to insert the next one. I select the handle and I'm just going to click it over here somewhere. So now I'm going to constrain this circle to that circle and mate it, and I'm going to flip it around. So I have something like that. So the way I actually made it is I held the control key and I clicked both parts before I clicked the mate. You can do it that way. I have a habit of doing it that way, but you can also select the mate first and select the two parts. So now that we are still in the mate, so we want to mate this edge, that face, sorry, to this face, and click OK. So now this part is still spinning, which I kind of want this logo on this top part of it. So what I can do is close that and open this file, and I want to find the center plane of that handle and also the center plane of that body, which is the right plane and the front plane on that. and I'll meet those two together and it's a call coincident mate and click OK. And now that top face is in the center. So we're just going to keep working along and bringing new parts in and mating it. So bring a new part in. We'll select this part. So it's this part that looks like the Batman symbol. And we'll bring that in. And just click. Well, let's do it this way. Click the mate. Once you're in the mate, click this face and click this face. And make it concentric with each other. And now click the bottom face and also click that face to mate it on the inside. So you have something like that. Click OK. Next thing, insert components, browse, and you want to bring in the direction letter and bring that in. And just click somewhere over here. And I'm going to just rotate it. And the way I'm doing this is holding down the right click and just spinning it until I have it rotate to the point. I'm going to select the mate, select this circle and select that face and mate those two together. It's going to be concentric. And I'm just going to pull this up. So that is up, and I'm going to select this face and I'm going to select that face to mate those two sides together. So I need to select my face, that face, to mate those two sides together, that when I move this, that also moves with it. And now all I need to do is select this face and that face to mate everything together. One thing I noticed I didn't do is add a chamfer to this edge. So what you can do is open this part, and maybe once I'm done, I would open that part back up and I will add a chamfer to it. So, okay. So I think I made that the wrong way. So let me just go down and delete my mate. And I'm glad that happened, so that way you don't make the same mistakes too. So let me just delete my mate on that, on those two parts. So I can move this out now. So while this part is this way, and this part should be facing down, I already have the concentric, I need that. So what I want to do is mate this face. Let me go back into the mate this face with that face. I think I had it the opposite way the first time. And now I'm going to mate this face with that face and click OK. So now my part is actually on the right part. So now when I spin this, that should spin. And that's what we want. Okay, and click OK. Let's bring in the next part in, because I think I'm kind of moving slow. Bring this part in and click OK and bring it in here. Select mate, select that face, mate those two together. It's going to be concentric. Bring this part up, select this face and that face, mate those two together, and we are done with that. And I really don't know the configuration for the shaft, but I found this, the dimension for this range on GrabCAD. I can never say it right, but if you know much about this, please feel free to leave a comment on how this range is actually configured. But what you are looking for is this two part fitting in there, because it's going to stop this from spinning. I think that's how it works. And we're going to bring the next part in, insert, and we'll bring in direction pane and click open and just bring that in. And once again, I'm going to rotate it this way, select this, no, let me click the mate, select this part and select that and mate together. And let me just drag this out And what I would do is drag it out, select this face and that face, and meet it together. And that is done. And the next thing we are going to do is bring in the pin. So insert the pin, which is that part, mate this, again mate this face and that face together, and just drag it up a little bit. So what we want to do now is I would like to mate this opening part. I want to mate it so it's facing this part. So what I'll do is open the folder for that pin, and I will find that plane. It looks like it's the right plane. And I will also open the shaft, and I'll find the plane, and it looks like it's the right plane for that too. And I'll mate those two together. So now these two are kind of facing each other, and we are done with that. And click OK. And insert again, bring the ball in and click open. And now I'm going to select this ball again, mate, select that ball, select this face. You want to make it concentric, and you want to select this ball again and select this angled face, and you want to make it tangent to each other, and click OK. So now when you pull it up, I'm gonna pull it up something like that, so the ball is sticking out a little bit. So again, I don't know how the configuration is in this shaft, so if you know much about it, please feel free to leave a comment. I'll actually like to learn about how this shaft work. And so we'll be done with that part for now, and I think we are pretty much done with everything on the inside. So what we need to do now is bring in our back cover plate, which we have open, bring that in and mate this and this face together so they are concentric with each other. And we can just drag this up a little bit, and we can mate this this face and that face together so they are also concentric. So now we just need to mate this face to that face and click OK. So we have that. Everything looks pretty good. And there's one more thing we need to do that I didn't do. So let me bring in my bolts. Bring in the bolts, click OK. And now one thing I need to do is I didn't make the counter. The counter, I think, is counterable for this back part of the body, and I need to do that now. So I need to first of all measure this bolt, because I don't remember the dimensions I use. So what you can do is evaluate, measure, and I'm just going to click this. Let me bring this in so you see what I'm doing. So the diameter of that is 0.15, and I will also measure this face to this face, and the distance is, which is the black one, the distance is 0.019. I'm just showing you all this stuff to see sometimes how you can work within the assembly. 0.019, and a good way to verify it is if I go into that bolt, and I can, if I try to edit it now, it's going to ask me to save it. So I'm going to try to edit that feature, and I'm just going to, yes, save the assembly. I'm just going to save it as wrench and click save. And okay, and that is actually 0.05. See, I messed up on that. 0.05. So it is 0.05. So I'm just going to exit out of it. And so our sketch is 0.15. And let me review that again. Yeah, the sketch is 0.15. And a good way to do it is if you right click on this part and you can open the file itself so you can review it. So this is 0.15 and the extrude is 0.05. So I have that down. So I just close this, save it, and it's going to update it in the assembly. And let's open this body. So this body, let's open it, right click on it and open it. And this back part, we're going to click on it, on that face, and sketch. And where those two circles are, we're just going to draw a circle there. Something like that. Make sure the circle is on the center point of that circle already, and make it equal to each other, and that will be, and the dimension of this circle will be 0.15, and that is fully defined. And what we can do now is extrude, cut it down 0.05, and click OK. So we have that. So what we can do now is just add a chamfer to this, because there's no part that is really straight. There's always a chamfer on it. So I'm just going to do 0.015 for the chamfer, and I'll click that edge. Maybe that is too big. I'm 0.005. I'll try that. Yeah, I just want something small. Now I'm going to add that chamfer to all that edge and click OK. And now save that and go back into the assembly, and we have that. So now we just want to add this bolt in. Again, click mate. That face and this center face, that is together. And now we want to select this face and that face and bring those together too. And that is done. So you can bring the bolt back in again. You can bring the bolt back in to do the same thing. Or what you can do is, let me show you another thing you can do in the assembly. You can mirror that bolt to the other side. So if you hover over this linear component pattern, you have the mirror components down there. Select that. It's going to ask you which plane do you want to mirror it by. Which this one we want to mirror it by, our right plane. So we select the right plane, and the components to mirror, we select the body. And as you can see, the body has been selected. We'll click OK. And now our body has been mirrored to the other side. And that, if you need to edit that part, is under this mirror component. So if you drop down, you see the bolt in there. And that is pretty much this entire part. The only part, like I said, the only part I'm not sure about is this bolt part. So if you know what it should be, let me know and leave a comment, please. And all you can do now is, and if you, what we can do is we can fix this part. We can fix this part. So if you right click on it, you can fix it so it doesn't move. But then when you do that, everything doesn't move either. So I really don't like doing that. Or I can right click again. You can click float and everything moves again. But I still need to know, I still need to learn how that board sits in there and how everything fits together. Anyway, this is this part. Lexo asked me to make the assembly, and that is the assembly. Thank you, and I will see you in the next tutorial. Bye.